Peter Ricky takes us to his junket interview with its major stars early this month in New York City.
My real life was my grandma was able to go to a local supermarket and buy a chocolate lollipop with my
family. Wow, what a big change.
Yeah.
You know, actually, Narnia really has changed my life. And it hasn't changed superficially, but professionally, I'm really, you know, I think grown up a lot. And also, you know, physically and emotionally. So I think I've been very fortunate that I've had the experience of growing up in Narnia, essentially. So, you know, as an actor, I think I've really, you know, learned from it, and I'm ready to, you know, just keep on from here on out.
Yes, this is the movie we're really familiar with.
Yeah, I mean, I read books when I was younger, and then I reread them during the audition process for the first film, and I think they're wonderful.
I got my first audition. And then I had the audition, I reread it, and then when I got the part, I read the others. And I thought it was really great. I was got captured in this amazing, fantastic world that had brought up such atmosphere, and I was really excited to be part of this project, I'm really honest.
You know, actually, I was, and I used to listen to the story tape every night before bed, and I
think you did.
Yeah. And I used to go to sleep to Narnia. So essentially, my dreams from about the age of 9 to 11 were in Narnia. So actually, like, coming up with this plot was kind of bizarre, because I already had an idea of what the character was like, but it wasn't me in the thing. And then finally, when I got the part, I realized, wow, I'm now going to be, you know, envisioning everybody else that I did. Yeah. I better do a good job.
How did you go with the changes of locations from New Zealand to Istanbul?
I really like going to different places. I mean, I love travel. I think, you know, we live in such a beautiful world and stuff, so I'm going to see as much of it as I can. Jet lag is definitely a massive thing, or the actual flight to New Zealand, because when you're getting on the second leg of your plane, you're moving on something.
We did move around a lot more with this film, and a lot more of the locations that you'll see on screen are real. And we only saw the film for the first time the other night, but some of the beautiful places we were filming in New Zealand look as though they'd been computer generated. I can't believe it. You know, we go to all the trouble of going to these remote locations, and they just look so beautiful, they almost look fake.
We embraced it. We just went out and we lived the day, and we took it in New Zealand, for example, when we got to Queenstown, which is the adventure capital of the world. We went, we did bungee jumps. We did Auckland, we jumped up, we did base jumping, we did all these incredible things, and I thought it was really great how, you know, that we realised how privileged we are, because not everyone gets this chance of travelling around the world, you know, and see all these amazing locations and just sort of see the best.
I think what I enjoyed most about shooting was, you know, just hanging out with the people and, you know, being on these incredible locations, as Sandra says, but also, you know, the learning curve, you know, you really learn an incredible amount in the 7-month period, you know. You learn how to be a professional actor, and I feel that's extremely difficult, and whoever does it well, I think my hat's off to them, because it isn't an easy job, so.
How were you able to identify your character, Susan and Lucy, in the movie? How are you different from them and similar to them?
I think that I actually have taken a lot of things from Lucy. I think she's actually made me a different kind of person. I mean, she's made me braver, because she's a lot braver, and then I've learned to like take more risks. And
I think people always seem to know how you like your character, but we're actually not the same people, Susan and I. I mean, it is acting kind of the point, but there are some similarities. Susan's certainly got a lot more common sense.
So you five actors, Anna, Georgie, William, Connor, and then come from different backgrounds. How are you able to blend so beautifully?
I think we all, I think the full tendencies, we all come from the same different backgrounds, but we all come from different places.
I think George is right. I think we do have kind of family vibes in common, and the fact that we all fit together so well is partly because we have very grounded families.
She really wanted to be an actress. She started in the acting very end.
Yeah, it was actually a complete accident. It wasn't something where I was six and I said, right, Mom, I'm going to be an actress.
I was always one of those people who was always in the school play and always dancing in the pantomime and things. I never really got far until I auditioned for my Which Medium. It was my first project and I seriously got thrown in at the deep end. But, you know, I always wanted to perform and act and things, but I never thought it would come in this form.
What was the best lesson that you learned from?
I think the best lesson I learned was actually how, you know, open people are and how cosmopolitan the world is, because, you know, everybody does have their own individual personalities, you know, culture specific where they're from. However, you know, people generally are very open and they're very kind and they really do give to you, and you know, and you expect to give back to them. So you actually become much more culturally aware by travelling around. So I advise anybody to take a trip.
Yes, I think it's incredible how lucky we are to, you know, we were able to experience so much culture and go, you know, all around the world and experience all these different societies and cultures. And I really feel you that opened our eyes, and you know, it's better than sort of staying in England, you know, it's raining and cold. So it's really, you know, really amazing.
I read the books when I was, you know, 8 years old, so it had been a long time.
Did you ever imagine that you'd be in a movie like this one?
Not really. No. I mean, it was a dream come true to be able to be in a